Mshonga. He's been with me for a long time. The first name is Henry Mshonga. Thank you.
The media, I think we have been introduced, if you're not here initially, we cannot delay the process, we'll continue. Minister, I want, before we begin, to understand the role you please have to play. I would want to understand the role you please have to play, because this invitation is directly to you as the former minister of the mines.
Yes, I'm listening.
So, I'm asking that the invitation was directed to you and not to the PS. So what role do your PS have to play? Because certainly...
No, they won't play any role. They'll just sit and listen.
So can I then ask them, because with respect to the minister, to not sit at the back?
And I've been here several times and I've been allowed to bring anybody to sit with me.
I like what you're saying, Minister. I think you agree with the new dispensation, as you know. So this is also the new dispensation.
I don't need your lecture for
you. So can we kindly ask your I'm doing this for a point of view, otherwise I'm not supposed to be here. If you want to be attending, please, I'm starting to go and sit in the
room. I'm a member of order, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Chairman, my point of order to the Honourable Minister. The Honourable Minister has pointed out clearly that to our Chairman of the Committee, Honourable Mliswa, that he doesn't need a lecture from you. And I feel that if he has to withdraw that for the sake of respect.
Minister, it's your choice of your words, but can you get your place to go and sit in the gallery? They can follow the procedures in the gallery. Thank you very much. Thank you. Gentlemen, you find yourself in the gallery. Thank you.
I'm not going to withdraw.
Okay. May you take off. May your assistant take off.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, that's in cabinet light.
I'm sorry.
That's what's happening.
Yeah, baby.
I swear that the evidence that I will give is the truth, the whole truth, and nothing else but the truth. So help me God.
Minister, let me remind you that the standing order rules of parliament is very clear. The witnesses, how they're going to discharge themselves. And this must be taken note. You shall be charged of contempt if you willfully fail or refuse to obey any rule, order, or resolution of the parliament. I ask you to withdraw your statement, and now I'm asking you again, and I'm guiding you according to this rule. May you withdraw your previous remark on that you don't need to lecture, because no one is a lecturer here. We are here to members of parliament, and for the sake of progress, I'll ask you to withdraw that statement.
I cannot withdraw a statement which I made before I was sworn in.
The sake of progress, we move on this, and we always expect leaders like you to also respect other members of parliament. I think it's not even about the all, it's about us being all members of parliament, having to think and respect each other. I thank you. Minister, you are before us in terms of a letter which was written to you. As you are aware, the purpose of this meeting is for you to give a detailed explanation on the operation and production levels at the Chiazza Diamond Fields and the alleged loss of 15 billion diamond revenue and mining policies implemented during your stint as Minister of Mines and Development. And I think the letter also said that you, should you require further clarification, please contact Mrs. Matanuka, who is our committee clerk. So you also agree to contact the clerk if you need any clarification. Minister, I want to welcome you to this August House. Thank you for being here. We are not here on witch hunting expertly. We are not. We are members of parliament who are here to oversize our role of oversight. And in so doing, that's where you find yourself. You are equally here to account to the members of parliament as also expected of the various offices that you have and so forth. I think you're aware that section 1087 of the constitution is very clear in that you shall account to the parliament. This is the Mines and Portfolio Committee, the Mines and Energy Portfolio Committee. It's invited you in a formal capacity as former Minister of Mines and Mining Development. Minister, I will give you this opportunity to go into detail on the areas that I did explain to you on the operations of the diamond sector mining in this country, the 50 billion that we also was in mention. At this juncture, I will give you the rest. Thank you.
Thank you. I just want to thank the honorable members in this committee.
Minister, I don't think we are honorable members. You failed to say no, we are not honorable in your eyes. Proceed with your detailed report. Thank you.
Did you say you are not honorable?
You failed to apologize and retract in front of these honorable members, and you weren't as honorable. And you failed to recognize us, you failed to recognize the chair and the committee in saying, can you retract? So I think go straight into the business of the day so that we don't waste much time trying to be patronize each other when there's no need. Let us respect each other.
You say you respect each other.
Minister, this is not the Zambia politician or where the minutes are coming from. Please take this city seriously. The whole world is watching you. You've come here and I've told you why you are here. So it's not an exchange between you and me. You are here to answer. And you can be here until tomorrow until you answer. So the sooner we get on with the business, the better for you and all of us and the better for the country.
You are not allowing me to speak. You asked me to speak.
Speak to issues that you've been asked to talk about.
What
issues that you've been asked to talk about is for you to give a detailed explanation on the operations of the diamond mining that happened in Kiwato when you were Minister of Mines and Mining Development. That's the agenda.
Can you please allow me to speak? But before I deal with the issues that you have raised, I just want to have a few things recorded. I was invited to this committee to appear on the 19th at 10 o'clock. And just a day before the 19th, I was called by Ms. Dingani that the meeting had been postponed. Indefinitely, and they were in her office. And since that time, I wasn't told about this meeting until I read the date in the newspaper, and my PA frantically called the parliament. I've not received any letter, and even the time or level clock was after my secretary had to call some people in here. I'm a former minister, as you kept on repeating. And there is a minister in that ministry. And I was a minister, I think, since 2008, and left the Ministry of Mines in 2018. And that time there was a committee, a similar committee like this one, where I was subjected to this kind of questioning. I moved to another ministry,
And this point of order, there are no questions that have been asked by this committee. So I don't know which questions you are referring to.
Okay.
After your question.
Okay.
It seems you're pretty, I think you went into a caucus, Minister. Can you get away from the caucus? And then, because no one asked a question in this committee. All I say is that before us, you were supposed to give us a detailed report. You asked to be given time, we're given time to speak. We're still waiting for the report.
I thought I was allowed to make my remarks on the developments leading to our meeting now. I am not Minister of Mines. And I don't know which precedence has been set. If you tell me that, I'll oblige. Where former ministers are subjected to operations which they experienced while they were in those ministries. If there's such provisions, then I'll oblige. I have no mandate to speak for the Minister of Mines. And you must be aware, comrade, that when I was appointed to that ministry,
I'm not comrade, I'm honorable.
You said you're not an honorable. What's wrong with you?
I said I'm honorable. Minister, why don't you take it easy?
No, but you're not taking it easy. Okay. Please, allow me to speak. And okay, Honorable Mliswa, please listen to what I have to say. It's me who has taken oath. You have not taken oath. I'm not Minister of Mines. And I don't think I'm obliged until you convince me that I'm obliged to talk for the minister. I took oath of office when I joined the Ministry of Mines. And I've taken two oaths of offices today where I am. And those the oaths of secrecy still stand. I'm actually under that obligation. I cannot speak for a ministry that I worked in 5 years ago. And nothing can force me to speak then. That's why I want to come here, cooperated, I've been abused by you, Chairman. You've said so many things about me in public. I've never said anything. Never said anything to any of the members here. I've never. About this, about what you've been saying, you've been attacking me, attacking my person, calling me all sorts of names, maligning me, and I kept quiet.
Yes, wonderful.
Thank you, Honorable Chair. I just want to intervene, Honorable Minister. We are a portfolio committee. We don't want to hear your attacks hitting the media and somewhere else. If you are just sticking to the point to say that you don't want to appear before this committee because you are not obliged, then that's what you can stick to, and let's see what the law says. To try and confront the chair and tell him what he is saying to her and how, I think that's not the business of this committee. Thank you.
You can say whatever, my honourable. You can say whatever. But I've been in Parliament since 1987. I know my obligations. I'm just saying these preliminary remarks are meant to be recorded because I've been attacked regarding these issues by the chairman in the paper, calling me names. Yet, after doing that, he Nicodemously comes to my house in the cover of night. This man, I live almost 600 kilometers from here. He drives all the way to my house to come and talk about this thing. And what does he say to me about these things? You see, gentlemen, we're not children. I'm a member of Parliament.
Minister, I think what you are saying. Let me just, Minister, Honorable Minister, first of all, Parliament can call anyone to account except the President. And you don't want to.
So I'm anyone, I'm not the former Minister.
No, you just said in under oath, I've come to your house. You've come to your house once when I was in Zambia.
Yes.
So when else did I come to your house to talk about what? When I was coming to your house, what did you talk about? When you talk about the politics when I was in Zambia? Because you're misleading the committee in saying that I've come to your house to talk about this. So can you now, since you've said, tell me when I came to your house to talk about this?
You should tell the committee yourself.
No, you are the one who is saying I came. Don't try and deliberate.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. With all due respect, Mr. Chairman, to you, Honorable Minister, I think we ought to respect this house. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we ought to respect us. We came all the way from home. You know, this is a parliamentary break. Mm-hmm. But as a result of the importance of the responsibilities that we are supposed to do on behalf of our country, we are here today to deliver our responsibilities. So, Honorable Minister, if you can cooperate with the House with regard to the request as to why you are here. If you can't cooperate with the House, please say so, so that we don't waste much of our time, as well as much of the time of the nation, as well as anyone else who needs to listen to this program. Then you give your word to this House, then we move on, we make a way forward. This thing of the history that you had with our chairman and all sorts of stories, it's not part of us. What we need here is to deal with the duties of the responsibilities that are bestowed to us as parliamentarians. And we are dealing with the Ministry of Mines and Energy. And on this occasion today, we are dealing with the mine sector, bearing in mind the diamond sector, of which we are dealing with the history of it, what happened to it then, from the period then you were minister. That's where we are much focused on as we speak today, so that we come up with the report of whatever we are supposed to conclude to the attention of the country. Thank you, Honorable Minister.
So if for as long, comrades, for as long as you sit in front of me, presiding over this issue, I will not cooperate. I will not cooperate because you are even stopping me from telling you what he had come to do in my house. For as long as you are sitting there, I will not cooperate.
Honorable Minister, I think you want to divert the attention of a lot of issues. I have told you, and I keep repeating this book, which clearly says presenting to Parliament or a committee any false and true fabricated or falsified documents or anything with intent to deceive Parliament is not acceptable. You want to divert that I came to House. I came to House once when I was the provincial chairman of Zambia in Toronto, and I was talking to about Deep Masuda when he was fired. And you're telling me how great it was. So this is not the day to day. So don't try and divert attention and try and lie. And try and lie and say,
I will not accept deliberations that are chaired by you. You can do whatever you want.
We are talking about press reports about listening to the press. That's not the issue. Can you stay to the business of the day and don't try to divert attention?
I've got a point of order, Chair. I asked the Chair if the minister can be excused so that we deliberate on our own. As a committee, first, I ask that we deliberate on our own first before the minister comes back.
Can I guide members of parliament? I'm appointed by the SROC, and you cannot undermine parliament. You have came with the right minister. Before you came here, to write to the speaker.
Yes.
To write to the speaker. Don't play us for games. We know these games.
But
you cannot write a letter to the speaker saying that the honorable minister is conflicted because he came to my house to do an ABCD, and you want to say it and you think we don't operate like that. This letter was very clear in saying to you, if there are any issues that you want clarity, you have every right to write to the speaker, to the back, and say, I am not prepared to go before honorable. So most companies do that, and that is handled in a proper way. Not for you to come today and think you can divert the attention to you and me, yet to the business of the day. Can we please get on with the business of the day?
At your visit to my house, implicated to the speaker.
Which one?
But what are you even talking about the speaker? You now want to bring in your politics in Matino. Now, why are you not being honest? Can we deal with the issues of today? Don't try to never apart. Don't be diverted. Can we help you deal with the issues of today?
Can I come here?
I just want to be clear so that at least the minister can see me properly. I think, like what Honorable Nsiami is saying, even Honorable Chair, that Honorable Mliswa is our chairman. He was appointed by Parliament. And it's really difficult for you, Honorable Minister, then to come today and say you won't say anything as long as he's sitting there. Yes, you might have some issues with him, issues which have nothing to do with us here as MPs. And I think it would be proper for you not to give that as a reason to say as long as you're sitting there, I won't cooperate. If you really feel that you don't just want to cooperate because of the reasons, then please, it would be better maybe for us to say, okay, like what you said, that you stay about 600 kilometers away. Some of the MPs, they stay more than 600 kilometers away, but they are here specifically for the job of Parliament. And they are here not because as the current Minister of Mines, but as the former Minister of Mines. And those are the issues which we only wanted you to discuss. We only wanted you to tell us about. It's not about the issues which happened before. It's a new committee, and whether our Honorable Temba Mliswa visited you at your house, whether it was yesterday, whether it was last year or 3 years back, I don't think those are the issues which he can bring here in Parliament. Because those issues happened outside Parliament. And we are here sitting as the Committee of Parliament. And we are urging you, and you have actually very, you made it very clear that since 1987 you have been a member of Parliament. So you know the laws, you know what is supposed to be done if you are a member of Parliament. So please, can you just cooperate with us so that at least we move forward? Thank you.
Thank you, Chair President. Honorable Minister, I'm full of due respect. You received the letter inviting you to this committee for this hearing. And you knew then that the chairperson will be Honorable Minister. You did not raise any objections. And you did not even talk to the Speaker, who is our boss. And now we come here, we are expecting to discuss issues. But now you are bringing in issues that I don't speak in front of you. Why then did you come to this committee knowing very well that you will not be able to speak to Honorable Minister? Thank you, Honorable.
Please, with respect to the Honorable Members, I will never, never be presided over by Mr. Mliswa for what has happened. And you should allow me to express myself. I will never. You understand? So you called me. I don't know why you are here.
I never thought, this is news you're telling me. I never thought ever in my life, why don't you divert attention? Why do you want that between you and me? You never, what is it that you and I have ever even discussed about in my other than Tasakani going to the party?
Do you have to travel 600 kilometers to discuss in Tasa? You were discussing about this committee. You had already started attacking me.
I said I was unclear. My attack you talk about in the meeting seemed to be the issue with what I say. And I have a right as a citizen to say the things that I say. You are here before us. You have a right to sue the papers. How do you know I never say that to the paper? Have you ever sued those same papers to defend your integrity? So don't divert attention and try and lie and not be under us for us to tell us what we're about. I don't know which we can gain your employer.
Remember,
I think let us stick to the rules of Parliament. Let us have a situation where the point of orders are coming through you citing certain rules. I think we must understand that. Let's not allow this to get out of control and be diverted. Okay?
No, Chair, I disagree. What I would actually say here, and my point needs to be raised. I can see here there's a personal vendetta between the two of you. And when there's personal vendetta between the two of you, as an honorable member of Parliament, I think everyone should, the media should leave and we discuss.
Go ahead and wash my hands. Just a minute.
Wash your hands. That's okay.
Chachaya,
materialist
Abudi, materialist Abudi, and the person.
Over because of what I wanted to say, which you are blocking me.
No,
I will never. And it shows the new ways, the Konoku, no one's of Tua, we are in Ghana.
Honorable members, for the purpose of things, say it. I've now given you a chance to say it, and when you're finished, tell us you're finished. Say it.
But how can I feel when I'm intervening every.
I will not intervene. You are under oath. You're saying what you're saying is being recorded. So say all the things that you have to say when you are done. We're going to the business of the we have that time. That's okay. Say it.
I'm not going to continue under you.
I've told you, say the things you want to say, and you still don't want to say.
I'm saying I cannot allow myself to be, you know, presided over by you for what I was going to say and what I've said. I'll never.
You cannot be disrespected because you have nothing to say. Yeah. You cannot say anything.
Chairman.
I asked you, what is it that you have to say about me? I've only been to your house once ever. I don't talk to you off the phone. I've never done anything.
Yeah.
So if you have anything to say before all, say it. That the Honorable Mliswa issues within here, and so
forth. Wait, what?
Chairman, the phone was a bit deeper, more delicate.
Members, can you follow?
Yeah.
The minister says he has things to say about this. So I've given him the floor to say. Honorable members, I don't want to have you ejected, and I don't want us to try and send you scoring points, political points. I'll not allow that. I will eject you. I'll call the Senate of Arms and eject you. This is a serious matter. The Honorable Minister. minister said that issues to say about you. Now say to you, say it. Yes.
I've said I cannot allow myself to be presided over by you. So I will not say anything for as long as you're sitting there.
You know that there's only one person who can deal with the facts, it's me. And you know why you're avoiding me. And you know that very well. And you shall still be presided over by me. Parliament has said it. You know that
never.
You will not get away with murder and you're trying to find something. What if you're saying?
Say that under oath. Say that under oath.
But I'm telling you that
you're threatening me now. You are threatening me now.
Mr.
Honestly, I've never seen this. I've seen chairpersons, I've seen Comrade Chininga, the late, I've had Comrade Shumba. Those are professional chairpersons. They never behaved the manner that I see here. And I'll not say anything for as long as you're in front of me.
I think chairman. I think Bona is a coming to total resolution.
You can sit here. I'm here. I've submitted myself to you against all the abuse, but I'm here. And I'll never talk anything about this particular subject while you're sitting here. Never.
I'm not going to discuss the issue.
Notwithstanding the issues that we have with Honorable Mliswa, we did not follow the due process. The due process that he should have made self-care to say, I'm coming to the committee, but as long as Honorable Mliswa is presiding, I won't be able to deliberate.
I'm telling you that.
Can I finish?
You see, because see, what you are saying is, you are trying to convince me, you will never convince me.
No.
You don't know me, you will never convince me. And I'll never say anything, no matter what you say.
I'm not convincing you, I'm just talking to the law. I'm not convincing
you. No, I mean,
there's no point in convincing you.
Yeah, don't waste your time.
You failed to follow the due process.
What is the due process?
You notified the parliament through the clerk. To say that you have been summoned here, but the person who is presiding has got issues with him, and can he be excused?
I'm saying
that. You cannot do that. You are an experienced minister.
I'm saying this.
Parliament for a long time. You can't come here full aware.
But he implicates the parliament. He actually implicated the, that's what I was going to say. That's why it's also important sometimes to allow people to come and listen to us.
I'm saying because of that the parliament is going to charge you for the conduct of parliament.
Yeah.
Because you did not follow the due process.
Please.
You should have followed the due process.
Just, and then you could have been excused. Just do what? You can never intimidate me on issues of... You can never intimidate me on issues of principle.
Yeah.
We're not intimidating anyone.
You are. No,
we are just saying.
What are you telling me? You have not said anything at all.
This guy is just arrogant. I think we're wasting time.
Thank you. Thank you, Chairman. Chairman, and I tell you that also. Now we should eat Iparu in town. But now we did it in Chairman. Because I don't ever overrule us because you are a chair or whatever. Yes, it's okay. It's okay to sort, but we should be free to say what we should do. Yes, give him time to go out and we discuss this as member of parliament with us. To understand our choice to gender party, not just to override him in front of us. He's our minister. And at the same time, what I say to show the nation. You already said, you remember what he said, Chairman? He said, Zimbabwe, I'm not going to put it in Zimbabwe. Is he a criminal? What are you trying to say? Who is listening? Yes, but this is wrong, Chairman. This is wrong. Yes, we are not going to allow. He's correct. Even if you go to Chairman, check your constitution. But you know, the Chairman, Chaplain, they should sit up. This is a duty run around the can I add so to Mr. Happy? But you are refusing. You want to choose him. What are you trying to do? To address him on front of us. That's wrong. That's wrong. We cannot tolerate this. He's free to say whatever he says. We call him to say what he wants to say. You should not put your words in his mouth or in his mind. No, that's wrong. He should say what is in his mind. And that's what we wanted to. He said, you know, he's not allowed to be chat with you. And it's finishing this period. We are allowed. Okay, yes, I'm finishing. This is over. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Minister, I have asked you questions in Parliament. You have never said, don't ask me questions.
you are coming, I will not come here.
That's okay.
So let the parliament, in fact, even this meeting, I came uninvited. It came out in the paper. It's all over the paper. There was no letter written to me.
So then why did you come?
I mean, because, I respect parliament, but I don't respect you.
I respect you, Mr.
Chair.
And is it true that you said what you said when I left? That's what invited formally, because I've not been invited. I want a letter setting the date and time. I've been waiting for 2 hours outside. I'm not coming to talk until I get a letter from Parliament. Because you want to abuse me.
I want to not discuss how to
do it.
Minister, can
I take
a seat?
I cannot be told by you that I'm not coming to talk.
No, thank you, Chair. We are breaking the lunch now.
I'm not coming to talk. You'll write me a letter.
But I'm not.
Don't treat me like, you know,
the kids. I mean, Mr. Mbako Kumbakoka is the kid.
Excuse us.